jam. This is my jam. Keep me partying to the end.
Hello, welcome to the next segment of my food vlog. Today, we're in Damansara Jaya, and I'm going to check out this new joint called Dirty Nelly's.
Hello, Slim. Hi, welcome to Dirty Nelly's. Come and take a seat.
Okay.
I'll join you right here.
Alright.
Ah, yes.
Okay, so this is Paige. Right, Paige?
Hello.
So he is the owner of Dirty Nelly's.
Yeah, hi, well, Paige. Hi. No, I'm not the only one who knows this. I've got a partner, Mary,
yeah,
who does rush hour on Fly FM. See, so yeah, I'm actually free plug, 95.8 in the Clare Valley.
Yeah.
Yeah, so yeah, pretty excited about the place actually.
Right. So from radio DJ, MCing, hosting, why Dirty Nelly's?
The first one to ask me that question, well, the thing is because, you know, at the end of the day, I wanted something to do. And for the longest time, I wanted to own a restaurant. And I wanted to own a restaurant that cooked my favorite food the way I wanted it. And, you know, finally Brent came out to me one day and said, hey, let's open a restaurant. I said, perfect time. And he had the same ideas as well, almost.
But really,
yeah. You know, you see, when you go to England, it's nothing like walking into a pub.
I get that.
Yeah, you know, even if it was just for a quick drink, whatever, the feel is just different. It's cozy, it's comfortable. You make friends after half an hour.
Yeah.
That's what I want.
What's Dirty Nelly's
known for? Okay, Dirty Nelly's is known for one thing. We try to keep is we try to make the food as authentic as possible, because both my partner and I share the same thing. We don't like fusion. I wouldn't want to walk into a Japanese restaurant and eat Japanese pasta.
Yeah.
Why would I want to do that, right? If I walk into a Japanese restaurant, I want to eat Japanese food. So we try to keep it as authentic as possible. We've got our food from different parts of England. And although we still have to remember the fact that we're in Malaysia, sometimes we need that Malaysian flavor. So there are one or two snacks which are, you know, quite Malaysian. But apart from that, everything else besides English is English.
Yeah. I see you have my favorite English sherry trifle.
Oh, yeah.
Do that.
Oh, please. When the kitchen closes at 10:30, every half an hour after 10:30, we roll out snacks.
Really?
Yeah.
So it's complimentary snacks?
No, you gotta
pay. Oh, okay.
But what we do is, we call them dirty snacks. Not that it's dirty in any way. It's just, you know, thought it's a cool name.
Okay.
So cool. Okay, anyway. So what happens is, like, you know, 11 o'clock, one round of snacks come out, maybe it could be. This is where we break the menu. This is where we have our dirty bloody mutton. It's actually Indian mutton curry, which people like to snack on all the time when you're drinking, right? We also have hot dogs. So they come out in trays, and then, you know, if you want, you just pay 10 bucks, pick up a tray, pick up a bowl or whatever. And that goes on every half an hour until the place closes.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, so you never run out of food in this place.
This is Nyx. She's the bartender at Dirty Nelly's. And she's going to show us how to pour a perfect pint today. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. the Dirty Nelly, Wild Wild Guy, and I'll finish off with the Sherry Tribal.
Okay.
Oh, and a pint of Guinness.
Yes, right. Sounds like fun.
Thank you. The poor man's pate with a layer of butter on top with crusted toast, and the English crab cakes with homemade tartar sauce. Sounds very promising. It smells really good. Shall I go inside? And we're ready to eat. This is just the way to do it in England. It has a mix of brown and white crab. It's breaded and deep fried to golden perfection. And this homemade tartar sauce is tangy and it's full of bite from the gherkins. This pork liver pate comes with some onion marmalade and a layer of clarified butter. I've always been a fan of pate, so I'm going to try some to see how good it is. It has this slightly gamey flavor, which I like, and it's smooth and creamy and goes really good with toast. Good stuff. The Dirty Nelly. This is a 300 gram patty made from beef, veal and pork. Just look at it, it's super thick. Comes with a layer of mash, bacon and egg. And in the patty, you have bacon bits, jalapeno peppers and cheese, cheddar cheese. Now it's time to get dirty. I'm going to put the chili on top of the burger and top it with bun. Oh, just look at it. Okay. I don't know how I'm going to start eating this, but I'm going to try. I think the addition of chili to this burger makes it a whole lot nicer, because it gives it a meaty, full of flavor. And I love that the egg adds a delicious creaminess to the burger. If you love burgers, you ought to try this out. It's really one of a kind. This wild boar pie is made with savory wild boar fillings, fluffy mashed potatoes, and baked to perfection. So look at it, it's really good, and I'm going to try it right now. Oh wow, it smells absolutely delicious. I think the wild boar filling is the highlight of this dish. It is chunky and the gravy is spicy. It comes with mixed vegetables. Okay, the English sherry trifle. This is the quintessential English dessert. Sponge cake soaked with alcohol. It comes with jam, custard and cream. The thing about trifle is, it is made with so many layers, so you have to go all the way in and get the best of everything. It is sweet, it is fruity, and it is boozy. Just the way I like it. Okay, so food is good. And the ambiance, oh, it's lovely. Thank you so much for having me.
You're most welcome.
See you next week.
Yes, sounds like a plan.
Bye.